Once upon a time, Luck met Intelligence on a garden bench. "Can you make room for me?" asked Luck. "Why should I?" said Intelligence. "You're no better than I am." Luck looked at him and said, "The better man can be decided by who performs best. See that peasant boy ploughing? Enter him, and if he gets on better because of you than because of me, I will always make way for you, wherever and whenever we meet." Intelligence agreed and entered the ploughboy's head. "Why must I plough?" thought the ploughboy. "I can make money easier than this." He leaves and goes home. "Dad, I don't like this peasant's life. I'd rather learn to be a gardener." His father looked at him in shock. "What's wrong with you, Vanek? Have you lost your mind?" "Well, if you must, go and learn, and God be with you. Your brother will be heir to the cottage after me." So Vanek lost the cottage, but he didn't mind. He went and became apprentice to the king's gardener. For every little the gardener showed him, Vanek comprehended much more. Before long, Vanek didn't listen to the gardener's orders and did things his own way. Although angry at first, the gardener soon realised Vanek knew what he was doing and let Vanek tend the garden as he saw fit. Vanek made the garden so pretty that the king took notice and frequently walked in it with his only daughter. Now, the princess was very beautiful, but had not spoken since the age of 12. The king had passed law that whoever made her speak would become her husband. Many had tried, and all had failed. "Why shouldn't I try?" thought Vanek. He arrived at the palace and was taken to the princess. Now, the princess had a dog whom she was very fond of. When Vanek went into the room, he ignored the princess and spoke straight to the dog. "I have heard that you are very clever, and I come to you for advice. There were three of us travelling one day, a sculptor, a tailor, and myself. We stayed in a forest one night. We made a fire and agreed to keep watch one after the other. The sculptor kept watch first and, to pass the time, took a log and carved a damsel out of it. When he was finished, he woke the tailor to keep watch. The tailor asked why there was a damsel. 'Well, I was bored,' said the sculptor. 'Perhaps if you get bored, you can dress her.' So the tailor made clothes and dressed the damsel. He then woke me to keep watch. He explained to me and said that if I got bored, I could teach her to speak. Sure enough, by dawn, I had taught her to speak. But when my companions woke, each wanted the damsel for themselves. The sculptor said, 'I made her. The tailor, I clothed her. I too maintained my right. Tell me, dog, to whom does the damsel belong?' The dog said nothing, and the princess replied instead, 'She belongs to you. What good is a sculptor's damsel without life? What's the good of the tailor's dressing without speech? You gave her the best gift, life and speech. Therefore, by right, she belongs to you.' 'You have passed your own sentence,' said Vanek. 'I have given you speech again. Therefore, by right, you belong to me.' The king, however, said that the princess could not marry Vanek as he was only a peasant's son. Vanek didn't want another reward and said the king must obey his own laws. 'Seize and bind him,' shouted one of the king's men. 'Whoever says the king must do anything insults his majesty and is worthy of death.' The king said, 'Let him be executed.' When they arrived at the place of execution, Luck was waiting and said secretly to Intelligence, 'See how this man has got on through you? You've led him to death. Make way and let me take your place.' As soon as Luck entered Vanek, the executioner's sword broke in half. Before he was brought a new one, the royal carriage arrived for Vanek. The princess had told her father at home that Vanek was right. The king shouldn't break his word. If Vanek were of mean lineage, the king could easily make him a prince. The king said, 'You're right. Let him be a prince.' After their wedding, Vanek and the princess were together in a carriage. Intelligence happened to be on the road and, seeing that he couldn't help meeting Luck, bowed his head and stepped aside as the carriage passed. From that time forth, it is said that Intelligence has always given a wide berth to Luck whenever he has had to meet him.